Welcome to the show. I'm your host, Amy Kardashian, not Kardashian. On this show, we educate and empower humanity. I bring experts, people who have story to inspire you to see your life in a whole different perspective. So I have a great guest with me today. Her name is Jenna DeTroia. Jenna, that's a DeTroia.
That was pretty good.
That's pretty good. I said it okay,
yes,
right?
Yes, you did.
Okay, and we are going to talk about how to empower our children to be their best. And this is a great subject because I have 6 grandkids.
Oh my.
So I want to learn from you now about how to empower our children. The more I learn, the better it is. So first, welcome to the show.
Thank you. It is fabulous to be here.
It is nice to have you. And please tell us a little bit about your background.
Okay. Well, I'm going to give you some basics. I grew up in a family who I loved dearly, but was quite dysfunctional, like many homes are, and some physical abuse and some emotional abuse. And when I was 9 years old, my mother got mugged. So I watched that happen. That was really rough. And it was my first experience of feeling really helpless. I was screaming, help, help. And everyone just kind of walked
by. I could
by.
Just imagine your mother, you know, she needs help and you don't know, you know, what to do.
And I'm just a little kid screaming, yeah, help, help. And no one responded. But due to her lovely feistiness and her ability, she was able to get away. Mm-hmm. But you know what? That did leave an impression on me very young. So if we fast forward a little bit, and I'm in school, I was bullied just terribly, terribly.
Oh.
And you know what? So was my family. When
yeah,
I really think about it, yeah. From eggs getting thrown at the car to whipped cream on the fence.
And why is that?
You know, I wish I had the answers why people do the things they do. Mm-hmm. All I can understand is how we dealt with it to try and move through very, very difficult times. You know, it was difficult. School
and
was difficult.
And where did this happen? What
well, let's
area?
See. Let me see. This happened. This was all high school. The bullying was high school, but the bullying of the neighborhood was mm-hmm. more when I was probably junior high, 12, 13, 14 years old.
So that's why you like to help children? Is that what
absolutely,
you
mean? Absolutely.
Isn't that amazing how we could teach our what we learned? You
absolutely.
Know, what touches our hearts, right?
Absolutely.
What touches our hearts. So you gained a lot of lessons how to overcome that and how children get in touch with their emotions.
So many lessons.
Yeah.
It was a soul-searching adventure up until 47 years old.
Wow.
I think I got it at that point when I began to write my book. But low self-esteem, just hating myself. You know, when you hear things your whole life that you're not good enough, you're this, you're that, very demeaning. It really diminishes. Oh my God, yes, it diminishes your spirit. And as a child, you are like a sponge. You take in information from the world, from authority, from your experiences, and that's how you make your foundations, how
yeah,
you're gonna move forward in life. And when it becomes tainted in any way, you get a false sense of who you are.
Mm-hmm.
And you buy into everybody else's experiences and words until you're able to overcome, rise above, and realize that you are fantastic.
Absolutely,
but,
absolutely.
It's something you have to learn on your own.
And yeah, unfortunately, right? But in every obstacle and every challenge, it seems like there is something when waking us up into different place.
Absolutely.
You know, in a way that we start to see either breaks us or make us. That's how I say it all the time.
Oh, that's so true.
Either breaks us or make us. So I know you authored books.
Yes.
Can we talk about those books a little bit?
I'm
how
sure
many books
can.
You have and
I actually
what
have
they
them.
Are all about?
I have 4 books, 2 that I've done on my own and 2 that were co-authored with 12 other wonderful, amazing people and 2 in the publishing process. So it will be a total of 6. Very soon, I hope.
Wow, that's a lot of books. What inspired you to write books?
What really inspired me was a drive that was within that happened at around age 47.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of look at it like a pressure cooker. You know, life happens, and you try to manage, and you try and cope, and you put things under the carpet, and you say, you know, I'm going to be fine. But you know what? I wasn't fine. I was just existing to deal with everything, even through my marriage. But at age 47, I kind of fell apart in like a million pieces.
So what did you do before that, before you wrote the book? What did you do before that?
Well, I've been a counselor and a speech pathologist for 36 years.
Wow.
I've always been in careers where I have been helping. It is who I am. I'm all about being a humanitarian to animals, to the environment, to people. It's my passion, and I will do whatever it takes to help transform every child.
Every child.
One child at a time.
One child at a time.
Yeah.
So how do you do that? Do you go out and speak about it? Do you have classes? What do you
All of the above. I'm a public speaker, an inspirational speaker. I talk about empowerment. I wrote through my books. I journal. I blog. I really have done a lot of tap dancing in social media, and I'm thinking about doing webinars also and having this wonderful opportunity on this show to be able to speak. But I do get my voice out there, and I volunteer. I help with Clean This World, I serve in the mission, and I do a variety of things that speak to me, because I feel giving back is what we're all about.
Yeah,
yeah.
I have a quote, giving is living. And not you don't have to give your money. I mean, if you have it, it's fine, but giving part of who you are, and who you are and the lessons you learn, that is more powerful, because you're really passing on information that other people might inspire them and change their life, empower them, right?
Absolutely.
So that's what you're doing with the books.
Yeah, the books are spiritual memoirs, the first two of them, and they talk about my journey, about what I went through. But the biggest thing with the books is that I know that someone's going to read one of those chapters, and it's going to remind them of something in their life. And if I could just help one person,
that makes your day.
That makes my day.
So when we come back, we are going to dig deep into what really happened at 47.
Oof.
What really transformed that thoughts, and what happened at 47.
Yes.
So we will be right back.
Thank you for calling Denim Revival.
Hate to say goodbye to your favorite jeans? Well, now you don't have to, because Denim Revival is here for you. Mail us your jeans and our professionals will fix it right up. We offer you all kinds of alteration services, including invisible repairs, let outs, taperings, and original hemming, or even have your own custom-made jeans. Quoted the best denim repair shop by GQ, Vogue Magazine, and LA Times. Denim Revival, your search for alteration and repair ends here.
We are back with this wonderful lady here, and who in person I met you. I met you over the phone, but then I met you in person last week at the Women's
Federation of Peace.
For World Peace.
Yes.
And I'm glad that you are getting involved with them.
Oh,
they're amazing. And
it speaks to me.
Yeah, I just get the title of being, I am their liaison officer. A special officer for the United States, and I feel so blessed to be part of this beautiful organization.
It's wonderful.
Yeah. Did you meet the ladies there? They're so
I did.
Amazing, amazing.
The synergy in that room was like
was
electrifying.
Amazing. Yes,
it was that night. Was that great?
Yeah, no doubt about it. So I want to take you back to 47 years when you had your kind of aha moment or something shifted.
Yes.
So can you tell us more about that?
Yes, sure. Well, the way that it happened is I was married at the time and feeling quite miserable, but not addressing it, just kind of existing through it, you know, go to work, pay the car, go here, pick up the kids, make dinner. So in my sleep, on two separate occasions, I woke up shivering. And I'm like, oh, my God, I'm sick. I must have a fever. You know, I don't know what's wrong. My husband said, oh, go back to bed. You know, you'll be fine. So I ignored it. And then the second time, I couldn't ignore it, because I heard a voice in me say, Janet, life is, and I might cry here, life is not supposed to be miserable.
Mm-hmm.
It's supposed to be wonderful.
Yeah.
And it's time you start. I'm stepping into who you are.
Wow.
So I listened.
Wow. At 40.
At 47.
Seven.
At
oh
47.
My goodness. Oh.
Yeah.
That is, I mean, that's a long time for you to be not in a happy place.
To hide.
To hide it.
I was very good at hiding.
Wow.
I was very good at
so
hiding.
So what happened after that? You made that decision
so
that
So I made
day?
That decision, and from that point forward, you know how when you're thirsty, you get a drink, and when you're hungry, you go eat. Well, I was thirsty for knowledge. Mm-hmm. I said, I'm finding out why do I feel this way if it's not right? And this inner voice is telling me that, and you know what? I'm listening. I went online. I went to seminars. I wrote in journals. I went to places in my mind. I studied meditation. I did whatever I could to find answers. And I wanted answers. I wasn't stopping till I found answers.
And did you find your answers?
Yeah, the doors kept opening of realization.
More and more, right?
More and more. And I had a 360 degree shift from 47 to now 58.
Wow.
How I view my life, people, and totally different. Mm-hmm. I see the graciousness we all have and the divinity that's in us. And
so what,
love it.
What do you think happened to you that you were asleep for that long, and then one day you had an aha moment.
You know, my belief is that there's programming and there's things that happen our whole life. We're conditioned. No one's at fault. Everyone is really doing their best. But, you know, you do have a choice. And as a child, you don't know. You buy into it, everything everyone's telling you, including my perpetrators who used to make fun of me and call me names. Oh, I'm ugly. Yeah, that's right. Oh, I'm not beautiful. Oh, I'm stupid. When you buy into that, it becomes your story. Mm-hmm. So that was the story that I lived for 47 years. And until I had that wonderful wake-up moment and continue to have these moments, I couldn't embrace it. I was not in a place. I must have, you know, you have that song, Cried a River. I think I cried a million oceans.
Wow.
I really do. I really do. But it's all good because it brought me to where I am in this moment. And that's about loving and living life the fullest and empowering others to do the same.
Yeah. That's amazing. I mean, I meet a lot of ladies. Mm-hmm. And they say, like, they come to my seminar or, you know, my speaking, they say, well, you know, something shifted in me by listening to you. But I think when they see someone like you and me and other ladies who really found our own voice and our own light,
so true.
They get encouraged. They want to be that. So the more we help other people, other ladies to find their light, the more they're going to help the next generation. What a beautiful gift that is that you have right now, that you're passing
thank
on.
Thank you. Yes.
Not only through your speaking, through your books, and sharing to tell people it's never too late.
Oh, my gosh, no. Never too late.
So basically, that's what it is. It's never too late.
It is never too late.
To
embrace
step
your completeness
into
and the beautiful being that you are here. To
absolutely.
Shine very brightly when you allow yourself to do
did
so.
Did you ever think why I didn't wake up before?
Oh, God, yes. I was the queen of berating myself and self-sabotage. It was very comfortable for me. I did it my whole life. But after I reached a certain point, I said, you know what? It's really not necessary.
It's done.
It is done. It is the past. Rise above it and be a light for others to see their greatness, too, because really, we're all pretty great.
Absolutely. So now what you're doing is you're reaching out to children because you want to start from the core of our development.
Yes.
And you are reaching out to passing the... You don't want someone to wait 27 years.
27, 30. Every year is too much when you're suffering.
Too much, yeah. And
every year is too much.
You want them to find their light and their message as soon as possible or before
absolutely.
They even develop it.
Absolutely.
What do you think the age where we start to think more about this?
Well, from my many years of experience, I find 8 to 12 seems to be a great time. Kids are, they're into curiosity, and that's what it's all about. And they're into learning about themselves and the world. And it's just a great time to really nourish.
Catch them and nourish them.
Nourish them, support it. And, you know, help them with the tools that are already within them.
And it will last them for the rest
of
their life.
It's lifelong learning. It is lifelong.
Yeah, so if you catch your kids at the age of 8 to 12, you are really... but they said the kids stop, you know, they really get a lot... From when they're born to 7,
Yes.
And then
the brain is growing. Learning information, yeah. Downloading programs.
I mean, it's always to start as soon as possible. But when you start to be curious, you have curiosity more about life.
That's where the seeds are ready to be planted.
Yes, planted.
And watered and
nourished.
And
you like to catch them there. Now, do you educate families as well? Like,
oh my God, absolutely. Absolutely. Okay. Parents are with their kids 24/7. If I don't help them or nourish them in their skills and embrace the abilities, how can they help their children?
Absolutely. No. So you do help them, but if someone have trouble with their children, do you help them how to deal with their children?
Absolutely.
As well?
Being a therapist for so long, I've always, you know, I walked into many dysfunctional homes, and I was there maybe to teach a child to communicate because I was a speech pathologist, but they didn't have milk in the refrigerator. Mm. So then it became really real. You know, then you learned what was really important, and to respect these families where they are. And to connect them with whatever I needed to do.
A lot of families, I believe, they don't want to go and reach out because they feel embarrassed. They feel, oh, we know what we're doing. And
that is so true.
And then we don't want to reach out for help because that makes us not good parents. Because we're supposed to know what we're doing.
This is true.
And we say the opposite here.
Yes. Well, you know, one of the ways I would embrace that is you build a trust. If someone trusts you, they're going to be open up. They're going to be more vulnerable, and they're going to be able to, tell you what's going on, what their story is. And you come in a very non-judgmental, ill-critical way, and you tell them they're doing a great job based on what's going on. And you give them just little tidbits of information that they can take little steps, because little steps lead to much bigger things.
Absolutely.
But it's empowering, right? If it's not the children, it's the parents.
Yeah.
It's really all around.
So now, if someone want to get hold of you, where they need to go?
Okay.
This is your camera right
okay.
there. You can Ta-da. Tell them.
Okay. You can. My website is recreateanewlife.com. My blog is recreateanewlife.blog. I'm at, let me think of my email. I have all new emails, jandit44@gmail.com. And I'd be more than happy. In all those areas, you can leave comments, ask questions. I do life coaching. I wear quite a few hats. Yeah, but I love it all.
Yeah, I know. A lot of people could really benefit from your coaching because you have done it all your life, and
yes,
and now your time for you to pay it forward. So
absolutely.
Thank you so much for coming
on
the show.
Thank you so much.
It was a pleasure having you and sharing this inspiring at 47. So there is hope for a lot of people here.
There's a lot
listeners,
of hope, folks.
Right? There is a lot of hope for you to see light through darkness and just have your aha moment. Thank you so much again for being
thank
on the show.
Thank you.
And I have a next guest with me. It's very inspirational. And you need to wait to see his story. Mm-hmm. It will make you cry. So we'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Attorney Eric Palacios. If you or a loved one has questions regarding immigration, call my office at 444-7777. It's important to hire the right lawyer to take care of your immigration needs. Call 444-7777.
My buyer showed me the sofa. I couldn't believe it was only $499. First off, I love the sophisticated and modern look. It's covered in a soft textured chenille fabric, so it's durable. Look at the sleek wood trim. But what about the inside, I asked. Well, inside it has superior S-spring seating that translates into support and comfort. And the accent pillows are included. Larry's price, $499. Now that's some bang for your buck. And with same day delivery, it can be in your home today.